The first artist I'll be showing and I'll be speaking with is Mark Lewis. And I think I chose this particular work and I chose this, you know, this piece and the artist because I think nothing represents our moment better than this image. You know, it says everything about where it is, New York City, about, you know, what the moment is. But before we kind of go in to speak about the work, I just wanted to say a few words about the artist, Mark. Mark is an amateur photographer who's based in New York City. And his work really tells stories about, you know, about people, about situations, about the city where he lives. I know in 2017, he decided to use his camera to help educate both himself and those to whom the work is sort of, about whom the work is and to whom the work is presented, to help educate people and to present it as positive force for change. When you're seeing images, there's nothing like seeing an image, right? I mean, words are very impactful, as we can see in the image here, but it's really images that tell the full story. And the stories that he tells continue to change, you know, as the world evolves, as we live through different moments in time. And so storytelling through photography, through these opportunities, you know, there's abundant storytelling moments. And of course, having lived these past few months in New York City, we all are so aware of what has been happening and how New York has been transformed from a city, you know, in the middle of this pandemic with the greatest number of, you know, coronavirus sort of, you know, infection to the way that it has, again, changed, survived, sustained itself. And I think, you know, what you've been doing is incredibly impactful and important and poignant to everybody, you know, and for everybody to see. And this image that we have here, Black Lives Matter, now showing Do the Right Thing, sort of says it all. So I don't want to take up your time, but I want to turn the table to you and to ask you sort of how you chose this image, where it is, for those who don't know New York, or, you know, where it is, it's in Brooklyn, but, and, you know, why that moment was so important for you to sort of to document.
Sure. Thank you, Natasha. I live in Brooklyn, New York. This image was taken right on Prospect Park South at the movie theater called The Nighthawk. I essentially pass this place every day. In the mornings, I go out for a bike ride, and so very early in the morning. And the message on the boards changed a couple of months ago, where they put out, now showing Do the Right Thing, Black Lives Matter. It had other things there beforehand. And so on this particular day, I was going to a protest at Grand Army Plaza, which was a bike protest. So over the past couple of months, due to the death of George Floyd, that sparked a whole wide movement around police brutality, systemic racism, and there have been a number of protests that we've all seen, essentially nationwide. So I got this image actually on my way back from the protest. And so I actually went to this location, and the words obviously there stood out, but I felt that I needed more to create the image that I was looking for. And so you can see the woman on the left started, she was having a discussion with another person. And then the woman coming into the image with a bike, I thought was quite telling because of, I just came from a bike protest. And then kind of all three coupled together or joined together kind of gave me what I was looking for. In this image, there's so much, one, about the Black Lives Matter piece. Do the Right Thing is from the Spike Lee movie, which came out in 89, which also talked about racism. So if you haven't seen that movie, it's something to see. So, and essentially I shoot black and white and color, but I think from my perspective around protest and movements, I think the images are more impactful in black and white. And so I kind of saw this image in a black and white setting. So again, on this particular day, I just decided to shoot this. So I sat there actually for about an hour, trying to get the right composition and the right people involved in the image, But before I was happy with the final result.
And I'm looking through your website, you know, there, you've really been there for during all the protests. There are so many images on your site with people marching. You're in the midst of it. You really are kind of, you know, you throw yourself right there, you know, along with the marchers, with the protesters. And I guess the question I have is, those are much more, there's much more going on in those images. This is a much more still, kind of quiet way that you portray this. Why did you choose this one as opposed to showing a much more kind of, you know, activist one in your other series? Why this one for this particular auction?
I thought this one was more unique than the others. If you look at social media, you will see a lot of images based on what you just talked about, being directly in the protests. Mm-hmm. So you do see a lot of work around that. This one, I don't think you see as much of. So I was looking for something that was a little bit more unique, which is why I wanted to submit this one to the Her Justice photo auction. This one just spoke to me more so, and that's why I submitted it for its uniqueness.
For that. And what is your association, you know, your involvement with Her Justice in general?
Sure. My wife, Susanna Saul, is one of the directors in immigration side of Her Justice. So I've been connected to Her Justice for as long as I've been married to Susanna. So first off, I'm so proud of her dedication to the cause of Her Justice. Every day she shows her commitment to make it to impacting the lives of those less fortunate, that Amy kind of highlighted the whole mission around Her Justice. So I always support the mission, and in any way that I can assist in Her Justice achieving their goals, I am more than happy to participate. And so since I've been asked to provide an image every year for the photo auction, I am more than willing to contribute. I'm very happy to do that. And hopefully it's a force for change in helping Her Justice to accomplish its mission.
No, this is fantastic. And you are an amateur photographer here amongst the right, you consider yourself to be an amateur photographer as opposed to professional, I guess. A question for you I have is, who are some of the important influences in your, you know, for your work, artistic influences?
Some of the more traditional ones, like I look at Ansel Adams's work from a landscape perspective. My primary, I'll shoot essentially everything, so I don't necessarily have I do have a focus, which is more street and documentary photography. And so I look at a lot of street photographers in terms of their work. One of the gentlemen who I follow is, his name is Maciek Dakowicz. He's a Polish street photographer, but he travels worldwide to do street photography, primarily in Southeast Asia, but he goes elsewhere. He's been very impactful in terms of showing me how to shoot. I actually had the privilege of attending one of his workshops in Vietnam. So his view and his way of shooting has been quite impactful to me, more so from learning techniques around shooting. And there's so much social media out there. So I really just look at a lot of photography, and essentially a lot of things will strike me. But from a street side, it's Maciek Dakowicz. From kind of landscapes, it's obviously going to the classics around Ansel Adams and some others as well.
That's great. Okay, well, thank you. I'm gonna move on, but I love your image. This to me says it all in the most poignant and quiet way. So I think that it's a great way for our conversation to begin. You know, in terms of what this moment is about and where we are and, you know, what we're all doing here and how we can all kind of be a little bit of positivity, you know, for the good, for change, you know, going forward for the future. And one of the most important things, I think, for photography is to point people in the right direction, to make us notice, to make us see. And that's something that you're doing. You're making people see. So thank you for that.
Thank you very much, Natasha. Yeah.